Welcome to all, myself Professor Deshmukh MS, presenting the theory lectures based on radial engine. For before going to starting the radial engine, we have to see the how the balancing is there, because we are in radial engine. Again, we are balancing the things. So balancing is simply we change the center of gravity to the center of rotations. We coincide. Then we can say that there is a balancing. For a system to be complete balance, both force and coupled polygon should be close. Okay, this is a consideration for the graphical method. Now the radial engine. Figure shows what? This is the crank connecting rod. You can say crank mechanism, which contain the bearings, crank, connecting rod, pistons, cylinder arrangement. Okay, and over the mass M. This is on the crank, but I mean the mass M rotated with the omega, and the force that is with radius r, that is m r omega square, that is the centrifugal force, and along the direction of the stroke, that is m r omega square cos theta. So in this case, we have to consider the primary direct crank and reverse crank. So and second, that is the secondary and direct and secondary reverse. So what is the basic difference here? You have to consider in primary, that is only theta, while in the case of secondary, you have to consider only the 2 theta. So this is the angle, that is 2 omega. So that the case, that is primary and secondary with the common crank. Now in this case, the four existence in the same plane, hence there is no couple exist. If there is a single plane, there is no distance between the different masses. Under that conditions, we have to see the there is no couple exist. In a reciprocating engine, the primary forces is m r omega square cos theta along the direction of stroke that I already discussed. But and again, in the case of the direct and reverse crank methods, the force identical to the force is generated by the two masses as follows. So again, that is m r omega square cos theta, but along with the strength stroke. Let some of the considerations for the primary, that is m by 2 and m by 2, these are the two masses that equally balance in up and down side with the angular velocity omega. And again, OAB the crank, imaginary crank, omega is the clockwise direction, that is opposite. While rotating the two masses, only the cylinder center in line means what are the cylinder that is the along the direction of the stroke, okay, or which is in line with the crank. The component to the centrifugal forces due to the rotating masses along the line of stroke are due to the mass A, m by 2 r omega square cos theta, and due to the mass A, that is again the same conditions, you have to, that is m by 2, okay. So you have to consider that half masses are attached. The total force along the line of stroke, that is m r omega square cos theta, which is equal to primary force. At any instant, the component of centrifugal forces of these masses normal to the line of stroke will be equal and opposite. So the crank rotating in the direction of the opposite engine rotations is known as direct crank, and the imaginary crank rotating in the opposite direction, that is known as reversed crank. So this is the basic difference, that along the crank is rotations, that engine, that is called a direct crank, while opposite to the crank, that is called as what? Reverse crank. Some of the forces which is generated by the two masses is similar as follows, that is with the length r by 4n with angle 2 theta, and that angular velocity is 2 omega, and the mass m by 2 is placed in the reverse directions, that is r by 4n with angle 2 theta, rotating with the velocity that is 2 omega in the clockwise directions. Now there is something, that the components of the centrifugal forces due to the rotating masses along the stroke, that is a c, that is m by 2 r upon 4n 2 omega pi square cos theta, that is m r omega square upon twice n cos 2 theta, m by 2 r upon 4n twice r omega square cos 2 theta, that is m r omega square twice n cos 2 theta. So this is the case, that is the 2x m by 2 r upon 4n twice r omega square cos theta, that is equal to secondary forces. So this is the primary forces and secondary forces, which is resolved by the resolving the centrifugal forces due to the rotating masses. So this is all about the case of your the balancing of the radial engine. So that's the case. Whatever in this case, you have to consider the reverse and primary. That you can say the direct crank mechanism. While at the balancing purpose, you have to consider that in the primary, that is M by 2. And while in the case of that reverse, that is the twice theta, which is opposite to the angle. So these are the considerations you have to follow to balance the free engine. The radial engine, quite simple one, that is crank mechanism we are considering, that in the radial directions we are applying the forces for the purpose. Main thing is that whatever the centrifugal force due to the mass m and radius r with the angular rotations omega, we got the mr omega square, and just resolving the directions to, that is mr omega square cos theta. So very simple case.